guys, it's Madison, and I'm the content developer here at Goldbio Technology. Today we're going to be discussing the common issues we face when doing our PCRs. The issues we're going to be discussing today are unexpected or non-specific bands, missing or no bands, weak or faint bands, and smeared bands. We're going to be discussing the causes and the solutions of these problems. Let's go ahead and get started. I went ahead and drew a gel for you guys. On the left-hand side, you'll see the DNA ladder in lane one, as well as I labeled the top, and those are the different well numbers. And in lane eight over here, I have our positive control. So as I go through these examples, you can expect to see a band at around 4,000 base pairs. So the first issue I'm gonna be discussing is primer dimers. So what primer dimers appear as on your gel is that you'll have your expected band, draw it in lanes two and three, and you'll also have a small band at the bottom that's very faint. And what these guys are down here is when the primers have complementary sequences to each other and they bind to each other, and since they're such short fragments, they make a small faint band on the very bottom of your gel. How to minimize this is to reduce the amount of primers you're using, and also you can redesign your primers so that they're not complementary to each other and they're just complementary to the template strand that you're trying to amplify. The next issue we're going to be discussing is contamination. What contamination will look like on the gel here in lane four is that you'll see a band around 4,000 base pairs again, and you might also see a band here. It's going to be around 1,000 somewhere that you didn't expect it to be on the gel. You might be wondering what this is, since you weren't trying to amplify anything that was 1,000 base pairs or somewhere else on the gel. How to diagnose this problem would be to run a negative control. You can run a negative control by using water instead of template DNA. If you have contamination in your reagents, meaning you already have some DNA that you weren't looking to amplify in the reagents, then you will run that sample that just contained water, and it'll appear in the same spot that you had contamination in your other sample. How to fix this problem? Grab fresh reagents, and what I would recommend is to aliquot your reagents when you first get them to minimize freeze-thaw cycles, as well as reduce the amount of contamination you might get. The next issue we're going to be discussing is non-specific binding of primers. This could present itself as multiple things on the gels, but one way that it could present itself is that you might get your band that you expected at 4,000 base pairs. You might also get a faint band at an alternate site. This could be because your primer concentration is too high and it's oversaturating your template. Optimize your primer concentration for the best results. You could also try increasing your annealing temperature to make sure your primers are specific. You could also alter the primer sequences and increase the length of the primers to make sure they're binding to the right place on the template. Also try avoiding GC-rich 3' ends, because these could result in secondary structures of the primers inhibiting them from binding to your template strand. Also try scanning your template to make sure there are no alternate binding sites for your primers. The next problem we're going to be discussing is when one band is missing from the gel. How the gel would look is that you would get amplification of the bands that you expected at around 4,000 base pairs, similar to the positive control, but for some reason in lane 3 you're unexpectedly missing a band. This could be because you might have forgot a reagent, which happens to all of us at some time or another. A good solution would be to use organized pipetting. Try adding reagents in the same order every single time you do a PCR. Also, be sure to close the tube caps after you add each reagent so that you know that you already pipetted into that tube. The next problem you could be facing is that you didn't get any bands on your gel. Your gel might look something like this, where you might have some primer dimers, as we discussed earlier, up towards the bottom of your gel. They're just going to be faint bands at the very bottom. You might also have some DNA fragments scattered throughout, but it's not the bright bands you were looking for. One thing you can do is optimize your annealing temperature by checking the melting temperature of your primers and making sure that annealing temperature is optimal for what you're trying to amplify. You could also try adding BSA or DMSO. BSA will prevent your reagents from sticking to the vial. DMSO will prevent any GC-rich content from folding up on itself and not being able to be amplified. You may also have reagents that aren't viable. Go ahead and grab fresh reagents and try it again. Double check your reagent amount with your protocol. Try typing out your protocol and leaving it on your bench in a vinyl sleeve. You can then use a dry erase marker to check off the reagents as you add them and erase them after you're done. That way you're consistent with the amounts you're adding each time and making sure that you added all the reagents correctly. You could also increase the amount of PCR cycles and re-isolate your template DNA so that you know you have good quality DNA that you're trying to amplify. The next common PCR problem we're going to be discussing is weak or faint bands. How this will look on a gel is that you'll have some amplification of the desired product, but the bands might be weak or faint and it's hard to see them on the gel. Some solutions for this is that you might need to add more template DNA. You could also try increasing the amount of PCR cycles. Another thing you could do is increasing the amount of primers you use, and you may also need to increase your DNTP concentration. The standard DNTP concentration is usually around 50 micromolars of each nucleotide. If you're trying to amplify a large sequence though, you might need more than 50 micromolars of each nucleotide. The final problem we're going to be looking at today is smeared bands. How this might appear on the gel is instead of getting your nice tight band that you were looking for, you actually got some smearing down the gel during gel electrophoresis. Some common causes and solutions for this is that you might have had a contaminant that was degrading your DNA, causing different length fragments which can look like this smearing effect down the gel. I would recommend using fresh aliquots and using those fresh aliquots to run a new PCR. You could also have too much template DNA, so I would recommend reducing that, or any DNA overloading in general might give you this smearing effect. You could also have run too many cycles of PCR. I would recommend trying to stick with between 25 and 30 cycles. Another twofold step that you could take to try to reduce the smearing is to reduce the extension time and increase the annealing temperature. This might make your primers more specific to what you're trying to amplify, resulting in a nice tight band. You could also try changing out your TAE buffer, and your voltage might also be too high. Try lowering the voltage and then running it for a longer amount of time and see if that helps with the smearing. We hope this helped you diagnose your common PCR problem. For more resources and PCR products, go ahead and visit goldbio.com. If you like this video, give us a like and subscribe. Thanks for watching!